Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you are new on this YouTube channel, kindly help subscribe. Press the notification button so that you can always get notification from us whenever we post a new video. Today, we'll be considering WAEC questions on SET. If you have not seen any of our video, you can check our YouTube channel, My Simple Maths. We'll be considering WAEC questions on SET like I've said before. But it's a topical series, which means a compilation of WAEC questions on a particular topic. Today, we are going to be considering SET. If you have not seen any of our video, kindly check our YouTube channel. Now, we have compiled a lot of WAEC questions on SET from different years. Let's dive straight to the business of the day. So, WAEC question, year 2020, question 1A is a SET question. So, this is the question. If A is a multiple of 2, B is a multiple of 3, C is a factor of 6, if they are all subsets of this universal set, we are asked to find A complement intersection, B complement intersection, C complement. Awesome. So first thing first, our universal set, we have been given the range. It is from 1 to 10. So, as you can see from the question, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's our universal set. That is the range from which we'll be operating. Now, we're given A to be a multiple of 2. So, from 1 to 10 in the universal set, we are going to bring out all the multiples of 2 that we have there. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Those are the multiples of 2 from our universal set. B, multiples of 3, 3, 6, and 9. Those are the multiples of 3 we have in our universal set. And set C says factors of 6. What are the factors of 6 that we have in our universal set? We have 1, 2, 3, and 6. So having done that, the question says we should find A complement intersection, B complement intersection, C complement. That is where the bulk of the job is. Now, what is intersection? This time around, considering our set A, which is the multiple of 2, we are going to look at the universal set. All the numbers in the universal set, or all the, if I say number or elements, I mean the same thing. All the numbers in the universal set that are not in set A is the complement of A. You can always pause this video and rewind to get better clarification and understanding. So, let's check our universal set. All the number in there that are not in set A is our A complement. So let's go. We have one here, but it's not in our set A. That's why we have one here. We have two here. There is two here. We have three here, but three is not in our set A. That's why we have three here. We have four here. Four is here as well. We have five here, but five is not here. That's why we have five here. We have six here. Six is here also. We have seven here. Seven is not in our A. That's why we have it here. We have 8 here, 8 is here also. We have 9 here, 9 is not in our 8, that's why we have 9 here. We have 10 here, and 10 is here as well. So we've been able to get our A complement. Awesome. So let's move straight to B. We have B, our element of B is already here. We've been able to factor it out, which is the multiples of 3. So we go the same route again. All the elements in the universal set that are not in our set B, 1 is here. 1 is not here, that's why we have 1 here. 2 is here, 2 is not here, that's why we have 2 here. 3 is here, 3 is here. Oh. 4 is here, 4 is not here, that's why we have 4 here. Awesome. 5 is here, 5 is not here, that's why we have 5 here. 6 is here, 6 is here. So we cannot go for that. 7 is here, okay, 7 is not here, that's why we have 7 here. 8 is here. 8 is not here, that's why we have 8 here. 9 is here, 9 is here. Then 10 is here, 10 is not here, that's why we have 10 here. So we've been able to iron out our B complement. Beautiful. So let's go to C. The same process. All the elements in the universal set that are not in set C. So we have 1 here, 1 is here. We have 2 here, 2 is here. We have 3 here, 3 is here. We have 4 here, 4 is not here. So we bring out 4. We have 5 here, 5 is not here, we bring out 5. We have 6 here, 6 is here. We have 7, 8, 9, and 10 here, 7, 8, 9, and 10 is not here. So that's all you have. 7, 8, 9, and 10 here. Beautiful. So we've been able to bring out our A complement, B complement, and C complement. Now the question says, find A complement intersection, B complement intersection, C complement. By implication, it means intersection is what is common between these three. 1, 2, 3. What is common? Okay, let's go. We have one here, one here, one is not here, so one is out. We have three here, three is not here, so three is out automatically. It has to be number that is in three of them. We have five here, five here, five here, awesome. So five is there. Beautiful. We have seven here, seven here, seven is here, so we have seven there. We have nine here, nine is not here. So the only number that is common, or the only element that is common from A complement, B complement, and C complement as required by the question is 5 and 7. Awesome. So let's dive straight to the next question. 2018 WAEC question, question number 6. In a roadworthiness test on 240 cars, 60% passed. The numbers that failed at fault in clutch, brakes, and steering as follows. Clutch only 28, clutch and steering 14, clutch, steering, and brake 8, clutch and brake 20, brake and steering only 6. The numbers of cars with fault in steering only is twice the number of cars with fault in brakes only. Now the question, draw a Venn diagram to illustrate this information. The second question, how many cars had 40 brakes? The second one, how many cars had only one fault? Now, you have to interpret this question carefully. So let's dive straight to it. Now, the solution, let's represent C as our clutch, B as our brake, and S as steering. So whenever we say C, it means clutch, B it means brakes, and S it means steering. Now the question says 60% passed. It means 240 cars roadworthiness were carried out on them, but only 60% passed. So let's see the number of cars that actually passed the roadworthiness test. So 60% means 60 over 100. Now we have 240 cars. So if you punch your calculator, 60 divided by 100 times 240, you have 144. By implication, it means the total number of cars that passed the roadworthiness test, there are 144 cars. Beautiful. But this particular question focuses mainly on the numbers of cars that had faults, that failed the roadworthiness test. So for us to get the number of cars that failed the roadworthiness test, we say total numbers that failed will now be 240, which is the total number of cars, minus 144, that's the total number of cars that passed. So we are left with 96 cars. By implication, our attention majorly will be focused on just 96 cars, because that is what the question is all about. So 96 cars generally failed the roadworthiness test. Okay, now the question now move ahead and said the number of cars that had fault with clutch 28, the number of cars that had fault with clutch and steering 14, the number of cars that has fault with clutch and steering and brake 8 number. The number of cars that has fault with clutch and brake 20. The number of cars that has fault with brake and steering 6. Now there is a statement at the end of the question. The question now says, look here everybody, the numbers of cars with fault in steering only, S only, is twice the number of cars with fault in brake only. Look at it. The number of cars that have fault in steering only is 2S. So we represent, because we don't know the figure value there, we represent it as X. So the number of cars that has fault in steering only is twice. That is what the question says. It's twice the number of cars with fault in brake only. So this is brake only. Now, let's say it is S. This is steering only. Because the question says it's twice. So we call it 2X. Beautiful. So this information that is available to us, let's represent them on a Venn diagram. Now, this is a Venn diagram. Let's see. We have, these are universal sets now, because we're actually considering those cars that has faults either with clutch, steering, or brake. Beautiful. So from here, we've been able to iron out that all the total numbers of cars that failed the roadworthiness test, they are 96. So our universal set is actually 96. Awesome. So cars that has fault in clutch only 28. That's why we have our 28 here. Beautiful. Clutch and steering. That's clutch intersection steering, where they are common. That is C and S. This is C and this is S. 14. That is their intersection point. Now, clutch and steering and brake, where three of them intersect. 8. This is it here. 8. Clutch and brake, 20. Look at it. Clutch and brake, we have 20 here. This is C and B. We have 20 here. B and S, brake and steering. Look at it. B and S, this is where they intersect. 6. Now, the question says, that last statement, the number of cars with fault in steering only, this is steering only, is twice. That is 2x. We don't know the number. We represent it as x. It's twice the number of cars with faults in brakes only. So this is brake only. Don't forget, we are giving clutch only to be 28. So this is it. Now, we need to get the actual value of C and B, because we have x here. We don't know the value. So there are some numbers that are here that will be here too. So we need to get C, the actual number between C and B. Now, how are we going to get that? Because we have 8 here in between. That means 8 is interacting with what? With this clutch. And is also interacting with this brake. Are you with me? So we need to get the actual value of our C and B. This is it here. To get the actual value of C and B, we have to say this 20 minus this 8. That is when we get the actual value of what is here, which is 20 minus 8 will give us 12. Awesome. The same thing we apply to C and S. C and S. The reason why is because we don't know the actual value of number of cars that has faults only in steering. That's why they say twice the number of cars that had fault in only brake. Because we don't know the actual value here, that's why we've done this. So we now know the actual value here to be 12. So the actual value here, we apply the same principle, because this is where C and S intersect. So we say 14 minus 8, it will give us what? 6. So the actual value here is what? 6. Now, the question says we should draw the Venn diagram. Beautiful. Our actual value here now is 6, as we can see here. Instead of 14, it is 6. Our actual value here is 12 instead of 20 here. Awesome. So we've been able to iron that out. So this is the Venn diagram as required by the question. Look at what the question says, that we should draw a Venn diagram to illustrate this information. Now, we've been able to get that. We need to get the value of x so that we can put our x here and multiply our x by 2 here, so that all our value can be adequate. So let's get the value of our x. Since our universal set is 96, all we just need to do is to add all the value here. We equate it by 96. Okay, let's go. We have 28 plus 6 plus 2x plus 12 plus 8 plus 6 plus x, because these are all 40 cars. These are one or two faults in all the 96 cars that we have, equal to 96. Beautiful. So let's get the value of x. All we need to do is to say 28 plus 6 plus 12 plus 8 plus 6. It will give us what? 60. Beautiful. So we now say 2x plus this x that is here. It will give us what? 3x equal 96. Awesome. So let's just collect like terms. Our 3x is here. Our equal to 96 that is here. So we are going to transfer this plus 60 down here. If it crosses the equality sign, it's going to change to what? Minus 60. Awesome. So we now have 3x equals to 96 minus 60. 96 minus 60 will give us what? 36. So all we just need to do is to make s the subject of our formula. We divide both sides by what? By 3, so that our s can stand alone. We can now have 36 divided by 3, which is 12. So in the whole, our x is now what? 12. So b only now is 12, and x only will be 2 times 12, which is 24. So let's put that in perspective. We're drawing the Venn diagram now. We now have our b only to be 12 and our x only to be 24. If you bring out your calculator and add all these values together, 28 plus 12 plus 12 plus 6 plus 8 plus 24 plus 6, it will give us what? 96. Awesome. Now the next question says, how many cars add 40 bricks? So since we've been able to iron out our Venn diagram, we can bring that out very easy. 40 bricks. Let's look at bricks. This is brick. Okay, there are some car that has this issue too. So we are going to consider the circle of brick. Look at it here, the circle of brick. So we have 12 plus 12 plus 8 plus 6. That is for brick. There are some cars that has all the 3/4, but if you are to consider those that has 40 bricks only, so we have 12, because this is a circle of brick. Look at it carefully. 12 plus 12 plus 8 plus 6, it will give us 38. So those are the numbers of cars that has 40 bricks. So the next one says we should find the number of cars with only one fourth. Look at it. This aspect means cars that has two fourths. In between years means cars that has 3/4. That means the car has clutch fourth, steering fourth, brake fourth. So, but the question is saying we should look for cars with only one fourth. Look at it. 28 cars here has only the fourth of clutch. 12 cars here has only the fourth of brake, and 24 cars here has only the fourth of steering. So only one fourth. So we have 28 plus 12 plus 24. You can see bringing out the Venn diagram makes our job very easy. So cars with only one fourth, 28 plus 12 plus 24, will give us 64. Awesome. So let's dive straight to the next question. WAEC question year 2017, question 5 is also a set question. The question says, out of 120 customer in a shop, 45 bought both bags and shoes. If all the customers bought either bags or shoes, and 11 more customers bought shoes than bag, illustrate this information in a diagram. Find the numbers of customers who bought shoes. Calculate the probability that a customer selected at random bought bags. Awesome. So we know our universal set now, 120 customer. Beautiful. So let's represent them. Let's say anywhere we see B, it means bags. Anywhere we see S, it means shoe. So the total number of customers, that's our universal set, which is 120 customer. Now the question now says, 45 bought both bags and shoes. Both bag and shoe. 45 bought both bags and shoe. That means B and S. Look at it. B and S, 45. That is what the question says. You have to be careful while interpreting your question. The question now says, if all the customers bought either bags or shoe, by implication, it means all the customers bought either bag or shoe. Look at this statement. And 11 more customers bought shoes than bag. That means all the customers that bought bag, you will add 11 to it. That will be the total numbers of customers that bought shoe. That's why we say customers that bought bags, we don't know. Customers that bought only shoe, we don't know. But they say 11 more bought shoe than bag. So if customers that bought bags are X, so just add 11 to the X. That is what the statement says, because it says 11 more customers bought shoes than bag. Okay, let's represent the available information on a Venn diagram. Okay, let's see, because we are considering just two entities here, bag and shoe. Our universal set is 120. So we have this to represent our bag, we have this to represent our shoe. Now, the question says, 45 customers bought both bag and shoe. That is something that is common. Look at it, it's common. That's 45. Awesome. They bought both bag and shoe. Now, the question now says, all the customers that bought bag, 11 more bought shoes. That's why we have X. We don't know them. But 11 more bought shoes. Just add 11 to X. So, first thing first, let's get the value of our X. We just add everything we have here. X plus 45 plus 11 plus X. So, that is what we have here. X plus 45 plus 11 plus X equals to 120, because that's our universal set. So, let's add up. 45 plus 11 will give us what? 56. X plus X will give us what? 2x. So let's collect like terms. So we have our 2x here equal 120. This plus 56, if it crosses the equality sign, it will change to minus 56. Awesome. So 120 minus 56 will give us what? 64. So we have X equals 64. All we just need to do is to make X our subject formula here. So we divide here by 2, we divide here by 2, so that 2 can cancel 2. We are left with X. So we now say 64 divided by 2 is 32. By implication, it means our X here is 32. And our X here is 32. We just add 32 plus 11 here to get our customers that bought shoe only. So let's put our Venn diagram in perspective. Okay, our B is 30, which is bag. We've gotten our X to be 32. So this is 32 here. Customers that bought bags and shoe, 45, still remains the same. Now, we've gotten our X to be 32. All we just need to do is to add 32 plus 11. It gives us what? 43. Beautiful, beautiful. So, we have our Venn diagram now in perspective. That is what the question asks from us, that we should illustrate this information in the Venn diagram. The second question says we should find the number of customers who bought shoe. So, since we've been able, look at it, find the number of customers who bought shoe. So, since we've been able to bring out our Venn diagram, it makes our job easier. Customers that bought shoe. So look at it. We consider the circle of shoe. Look at it here. Beautiful. So we have 45 customers here. Irrespective of these customers, they only bought, they also bought bag as well. But the question says we should look for customers that bought shoe. So these people in here bought bags and shoes. So they bought shoe as well. So we say 45 plus 43 will give us 88. So the numbers of customers who bought shoe, they are 88 in number. And the last question says, calculate the probability that a customer selected at random bought bags. This is probability infused in the set question. If you have not seen our topic on probability, you can kindly check our YouTube channel. This YouTube channel, My Simple Maths, we have explained how to solve probability in there. Very easy and straightforward. Just use that idea to solve this last question. Awesome. Very easy. A quick recap. When you are solving a probability, your final answer must be 1 or less than 1. If it is 1, that means that probability is certain. If it is less than 1, that means it is not certain. So, your answer, your final outcome should be 1. That means it's certain or less than 1. So, the question says probability that a customer selected at random bought bag. Now, first thing first, we need to know all the number of customers that bought bag. Look at it. We have 32 and 45. So this 45 here, like I said earlier, they are the customer that bought bags and shoe, but irrespective of that, they were able to get bag as well. So we have 45 here and 32. Those are the numbers of customers that bought bags. So the number of customers that bought bags, 32 plus 45, they are 77 in number. But the probability that a customer selected a random bought bags is total outcome of customers that bought bag all over the total number of customers, because you are considering a probability that a customer selected at random from all the 120 customers. So the probability of all the customers that bought bags, which is 77, over the total number of customers that actually came to that shop, they are 120. So all you just need to do is 77 over 120. You can leave your answer in fraction form like this, or punch your calculator. You still have 0.6417. It is still the same. Let's dive straight to the next question. WAEC question 2016, question 6b, is also a set question. WAEC question year 2016, question 6b, is also a set question. Out of 95 travelers interviewed, 7 traveled by bus and train only, 3 by train and car only, and 8 traveled by all the 3 means of transport. The number X of travelers who travel by bus only was equal to the number who travel by bus and car only. If 47 people travel by bus and 30 by train, represent this information in a Venn diagram. Calculate the value of X. This, you have to calculate also the number who travel by at least 2 means. By means, that means people that travel by 2 means and above. When you hear at least, that means that's the least. You can have numbers that are greater than 2 as well. Awesome. So first thing first, let's interpret what we have here. 95 travelers. So total number of travelers, there are 95. That's our universal set. So we are representing those that travel by bus with B, those that travel by train with T, those that travel by car with C. So the question now says 7 travel by bus and train only. Look at it, bus and train only, 7 of them. The question says 3 travel by train and car, 8 travel with the 3 mode of transport, bus, train and car. Now the question now says the number X of traveler who travel by bus only, travelers who travel by bus only, X were not given. We're also told that number X of traveler who travel by bus only was equal to the number who travel by bus and car only. Bus and car only. They said people that travel by bus only is equal to the number of people that travel by bus and car only. So XX, we don't know them. The question now forged ahead and said if 47 people travel by bus and 30 by train, look at it. If 47 people travel by bus and 30 by train, by implication, it means all the people that eventually travel by bus, you know, there will be some people that travel via other means too, but they also travel with bus. There will be some people that also travel via other means too. They also travel by train. But the question has told us that the number of X of the number X of traveler who travel by bus only is X. But this question is saying people that travel with bus, they did not say only. That means all other people has been included in this 47. So let's represent with Venn diagram. So our universal set is 95. All the people that travel with bus, all the people that travel with bus, 47. Look at it. All this circle here, that means from this 47, there are some people that travel with bus and train, inclusive There are some people that travel with all the three modes of transport. There are some people here also that travel with bus and car. All these people, that's what the question says, 47. But the question says, people that travel with bus only is X. People that travel with bus and car only is X. But all the people that travel with bus, some of them still use train, some of them still use car, they are 47, considering all this cycle. That's why we have bus, all the people that travel with bus, irrespective of some of them using some other means as well, 47. All the people that travel with what? Train, irrespective of them using some other means as well, they are 30. But all the people that travel with bus only is X, we are not given. All the people that travel with bus and car is X, because they say this and this are equal, considering the question. Now, since we have X here, and all the information with bus only, with bus, look at it, all the people that travel with bus, we've been told that they are 47 from this circle that we have here, 47. So let's get the value of X, since we know all of them to be 47. We need to calculate X. All we just need to do is to add all this, X plus 7 plus 8 plus X, we equate it to 47. So with that, we can get our X. So we know those people that travel with bus only. Beautiful. So let's get that. Let's say X plus X plus 7 plus 8. That's what we have here. X plus X plus 7 plus 8. X plus X is 2X. 7 plus 8 is 15. Equals 47. Awesome. So all we need to do is to collect like that. 2X is standing here. Equals 47. This plus 15 will cross the equality sign. It will change to what? Minus 15. 47 minus 15 will give us what? 32. Beautiful. All we just need to do is to make X the subject of our formula. We divide here by 2, divide here by 2, so that 2 can cancel 2. Our X will be left alone. 32 divided by 2 will give us what? 16. So we have 16 here. 16 here. We've been able to get the value of our X. Beautiful. We've been able to represent the Venn diagram. The question says we should calculate the value of X. We've gotten our X to be what? 16. Awesome. So what's the next question? The question says we should calculate the number who travel by at least two means. At least two means. That means two means and above. If it is at least, so we are not considering people that travel with one means. We are considering people that travel with at least two means and above. So we have two people that travel with two means here. We have people that travel with three means here. Okay, let's quickly do that. So we are asked to calculate the number who travel by at least two means. It means all those who travel with two means and above. Okay, let's see. This is two means. This is three means. So we can consider this as well. So we know our X already to be 16. All we just need to do is to say 16 plus 7 plus 3 plus 8. Those are the people that travel with at least two means. So we have it here. 16 plus 3 plus 7 plus 8 equals 34. So we've been able to iron that out. Because this is a video, you can always pause, rewind this video if there is any aspect that is not clear, so that you can listen over and over again. Please kindly help subscribe to this YouTube channel, My Simple Maths, and press the notification bell, activate it, so that you can always get notification from us whenever we post a new video. Thank you.